Hey Shopify store owners, in this video, Justin will be showing you how to optimize your Shopify store for search engines using Screaming Frog SEO Spider 2.30.
Hi, this is Justin from OSI Affiliate Software, and in today's video, we're going to be looking at Screaming Frog SEO Spider 2.3 and see how you can use this piece of software for your e-commerce website. Now, this app will run on Windows, Mac, and Linux, and it is free to try. There are going to be some limitations, but you can always buy it for about $170 or 99 British pounds. So just for an example, we're going to use Zappos' website to see how you can use this for your e-commerce website. So I'm going to go ahead and hit start. And one of the limitations with Screaming Frog is that it will only look at 500 URLs because I have the free version. Once you buy the paid version, it's going to look at every single link on your website. So basically what's happening right now is Screaming Frog is looking at every single URL within Zappos' website and see where it's pointing, getting what kind of web page it's pointing to. It's getting a ton of information about all of these links, and it can really be useful. Alright, so Screaming Frog has looked at 500 of these links, and now we can see quite a bit about all of these. As you can see, if I scroll left to right, there are a lot of different fields that we can look at, but we're going to go into that a little bit later. So first of all, you got all of these tabs up here to really help you drill down and find certain information. So all of these are the internal links. These are links within Zappos' website that point to pages that are also within Zappos' website. We can also look at external. These would be links that point to websites outside of Zappos. We can also look at response codes, the URLs, the page titles, description, keywords, H1, H2, images, directives, and we can do some custom searches. So the question is, how can you use this for your website? So one of the main things you can do is see how your links are going to appear within Google. So I'm going to go ahead and find the kids section, and we're going to look at how it's going to look within Google. So once I select a link, I can go down here to SERP snippet, and it's going to show me what this looks like inside of Google and a little bit more information. So right now, because of the length of the title and the description, neither are truncated. You can see every character that is supposed to be there. Now, because of the length of the title and description, everything is being showed up here. As you can see, nothing is being truncated. If we look at the pixels, we can see that both our title and description have over 109 pixels remaining. We might be able to use that. We could add an extra word here or in the description. Basically, we know that we do have some extra room to work with. You can also use this to see how many links are pointing in to your important section. So for instance, this is the kids section. I would imagine that is a very important page for Zappos. So if we click on this in links tab right here, you can see that there are a lot of different pages pointing into the kids section. I would personally be a little bit worried if there weren't this many. On this page, we can see the anchor text and where the different links are coming from. We can also look at outlinks. These are links on this page that are pointing elsewhere. We can also see the anchor text and alt text, whether or not they are follow links. But this is basically just a good way to see where you are pointing to and which links are getting a lot of links to them. On this filter option, we can just look at HTML pages or just CSS pages, etc. If we just need to look at one type. Here on external, you can see which pages outside of Zappos.com they are pointing to. You can see all the inlinks, the levels, etc. Response codes is a good way to see if there are any client error links, basically any broken links or server error links. As you can see, Zappos has been pretty good about that, and there are none. If you go over here to URL, you can actually see if there's any kind of problematic URLs, for instance, some with non-ASCII characters or ones with underscores. You can also look if there's any duplicate URLs, which would be a major problem, and any really long URLs. As you can see, this URL is very long, and Zappos might want to consider reducing the size of it. So look at page titles. Once again, this is just a good way to see if there's any that are over 65 characters, which there are. You can look at, as you can see, this one's pretty long. They might want to consider making that a little bit shorter. And you can do the same thing basically for description and keywords. On H1, you can see if there's any that don't have any H1 tags at all. As you can see, there are a few. Or any that do have a duplicate H1 tag, which could be a problem. As you can see, Zappos actually has a lot with duplicate H1 tags. You can do the same for H2. Now, images are very important for your e-commerce website, especially if you're trying to sell something physical. So you can see if any of these images are, say, over 100 kilobytes. As you can see, there are a few, not that many. You can see if there's any with missing alt text or alt text over 100 characters. As you can see, Zappos did a good job with that. So basically, Screaming Frog is a good way to analyze and find any problems with URLs or pages you have on your website. Like I said, with the paid version, you can look at over 500 links, so you can get a really good look at things you might want to fix. So for instance, if we go over here to page titles, and there's all these with over 65 characters, we can select them and export them. And this is basically just a good way to get these problems fixed. And like I said, this is also a great way to see your SERP snippets, just see how much room you have remaining. For instance, on this one, it's actually truncated by 9 characters. We can see that right there. So this might be something that Zappos should look into if there are 59 pixels that are going over. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Once again, this is Justin from OSI Affiliate Software. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure to check out our other videos about e-commerce marketing.